What's going on there, YouTube? All right, I got this 3406 cat injection pump, and I was just going to do a quick video of how to time these plungers and change them out. So the first thing is you want to take that solenoid off the back of the housing, or what I did is I just turned the key on. That way you could move the rack. So if you notice, I took this cover off and you can see the rack. That's the rack that turns the plungers. So when you move the throttle, that's what moves. Now, up top here, you have a bolt, and I used a 3/8 drill bit. Slide it down in there. And then move your throttle to the open position. All right, so that would basically be like you're mashing on the throttle, and make sure that it's up against your bolt there. They probably make a special pin cap, probably does, but that 3/8 drill bit worked pretty good. And now I didn't have to. Some people I've seen, they said you had to keep a bungee on it to keep it open, but mine pretty much stays there. So then you take your little socket here and unscrew your bushing. This one's already loose. Take your O-ring out and then slide your plunger out. All right, so if you notice, right here, you have a hole. You have a hole on the other side too, 108 degrees away, but you see how it's not cut out, okay? So we're gonna turn it back around. Because this is the way I work on it. And on the bottom here, you have this piece with the teeth on it. Let's see, you might not see it good from there. It's got teeth. And those teeth slide down in the rack. Because if you can see right there, on the top side of the hole there on the very bottom, there's teeth on that rack. So when you move the throttle, it moves them teeth. So it would actually turn this, and that's what gives you more fuel, I guess. And then on the bottom of the hole, if you notice, there's that little skinny pin. And I believe that it slides through that little groove there. So that's how you would line it up. Is once you have your rack centered, and if you notice on the very bottom of the screen, there's that little tunnel, not tunnel, I don't know, I guess a hole, passageway, and it actually slides right there. So what you want to do is have that hole lined up with that pin. And then you take your plunger. Take your plunger, make sure that it's square. Okay, it's not, it turned on me a little bit. So kind of what I like to do is get down here so I can see when it's square. You got to make sure it's square, that it's lined up. It should slide right down in there. Let me take it back out. It keeps moving on me for some reason. Let me make sure my, okay, my rack centered. But this is turned. It's kind of hard to do this with one hand. But I want to make sure that this level is with the level on that hole up top. I say I will put it in this hole. Oh. That way you can see it. It goes right down in there. If you get it lined up, it'll fall right in. Now, before I forget, up under this plunger, if you look in the hole, you have this spacer bushing. I don't know what you call it. Now, this one's super dirty. I wouldn't put it in there like this. But they say, I believe this is the piece that you want to, they say sand with 600 grit to get all that stuff. Because you want this completely clean and smooth. I mean, perfectly clean. You don't want none of that grit on there. But just for, you know, I was just kind of showing how to time them. Just, you know, make sure those pieces are clean before you put that plunger back. So once you get the plunger, everything lined up, falls right down in there, and take your O-ring, stick it back, you know, make sure you clean all that. And they say, I think you're supposed to put a little grease on that O-ring and take your bushing. And what I did is, because you know, it's got a little tension on that spring, is push down on it and then you can screw that bushing in. But that's how I done mine, and it solved the problem whenever I changed those plungers. Because I believe those plungers are sort of like injectors, because that cam on the bottom, you know, it pushes up on the bottom of that spring, and that's kind of what creates your pressure, I believe. You know, that was my theory of it. So, anyways, we'll see you on the next one.